I'm a mum as well. I run a business. Like you, got a lot going on, living a full life. I've had my highs, I've had my lows with postnatal depression. I don't want anyone getting up here telling me that I have to exercise because I know that. What I want to know is how the hell do you do it when some days you feel like you don't even have time to go to the toilet? And if you do get to go to the toilet, there's always a child or someone in there with you. How do you do it on those days that you're so sleep deprived, you feel like you need to have those toothpicks in your eyes to keep them open? Or maybe you feel so guilty to do something for you because if you're not at work, you need to be with your kids. Perhaps you've gotten to a time that you feel really unfit, you feel ashamed of your body, you don't want to go to the gym. Maybe the idea of exercise sends you running to the hills. Whatever it is that is getting in your way, I have experienced it and I've worked out how to bust it. When I was at rock bottom, I was full of shame, suicidal thoughts, and it was a trip to my doctor who told me, amongst other things, that I needed to put my oxygen mask on first before assisting others, which led me to doing this little 2-minute workout at my kitchen bench. And not only did that lead to the very slow, long journey from the downward spiral that I had got myself in, but it also led to this change of mindset when it comes to exercise. I realized that I was so stuck in this all or nothing way of moving my body. And that was, if I couldn't get to the gym or do the half hour jog, whatever it was that I did before kids, then instead of doing something, I would just do nothing, because exercise has to look that way, right? It has to be that certain amount of time, that certain intensity, that location, that piece of equipment, otherwise there's no point in doing it, right? That's exactly what I thought. But what I discovered from taking these little moments in my day to get moving was that my body did not care about all the rules that I had made up around exercise. Your bodies do not care. Your body wants you to move in whatever way that you can. Little, big, it doesn't matter. Your body was designed to move in order to get more focus, better productivity, so you're not losing it at your kids all the time. So you can have those aha moments, so that you get some more energy, some more sanity, feel at peace with the world, feel like you can actually cope, even when it's the last thing you feel like doing. So what I want to show you today, if you would join me in a little moment of getting your body moving, not in this perfect kind of way that's going to give you these certain results, but in a way that actually makes you feel joy. So I ask you, if you wouldn't mind, cue music, to get on up. And we're just gonna do some super simple little moves to get your body moving after sitting down, yep. Start with lifting both heels up and dropping them down, up and down, that's it. You can also take a moment to pop your hands on your hips, power pose, take your chest, open it up a little bit. You might feel like, oh my God, my shoulders have been down, down towards there, you want the back. Okay, now we're just gonna walk, let's go. You can do this in your work day. Great. Swing your arms. Yeah. Great. life for so long. The last thing we are going to do, I'll never forget this moment after I had been in that rock bottom place and had felt so disconnected from my children, from life, from everything. And my toddler asked me to dance with her one day, like they sort of always did. And usually I'd make up a bit of a excuse, or I've got to do the dinner, or I'd do it, but sort of fake my way through it. But this day I said yes, and I'll never forget that as I was dancing with them, I looked in their eyes like I hadn't seen them for so long and felt this connection to them and also this connection to myself, because I had totally forgotten who I was. And that is the power not only of movement, but it is the power of dance. And if you ever feel like it's just all gotten too much, or you just so low in energy or low in mood, the idea of putting on a great song when you're at home doing it with your kids or on your own and dance like no one's watching, it has an incredibly powerful effect of what it can do, not only to your energy, but also to your mood. I know that when you're feeling it's the last thing you feel like doing. That's why it's so hard. But when it feels like it's the last thing you feel like doing, it's usually the time we need to do something the most. I'm going to do a little bit of this last song, just have a bit of a dance with you guys. Remember, whenever you are dancing, dance like no one's watching, because no one ever is. Everyone's always just watching themselves. So yeah, you might know this song.